everybody. Now, as we continue our chapter, in our previous class we have discussed about sexual reproduction in plants. In sexual reproduction in plants, we have discussed structure of flower. Then to explain the reproduction in plants, we have discussed first pollination. Then we have discussed how the fertilization takes place in plants. And then we have discussed that after fertilization, how the seeds and fruits are going to form. And at last, we have studied about the structure of seed. Now, we will start next sexual reproduction in human. In male, male reproductive system is present. In female, female reproductive system is present. In male, sperms released, which is male gametes. In female, ovum released, which are female gametes. Now, at the age of puberty, okay, or we can say when the reproductive system gets developed in male and female, that age is known as puberty. That age is known as puberty. In girls, this age is nearby 10 to 12 years, and in boys, this age is near to 13 to 14. That means a girl's puberty age is little bit earlier. So, in the age of puberty, the reproductive system gets developed and the secondary sexual characters also going to develop. Now, what do you mean by secondary sexual characters? When at the age of puberty, reproductive system develops, that time secondary sexual characters going to develop in the boys and girls. That means the some different characters we can see in that age or adolescent or teenagers, girls and boys. What are these different? What are these characters? If we discuss that some common character between boys and girls which develop in secondary sexual characters, that the skin become oily. So in that age you can see some pimples on the skin because the oil become the skin become oily. Second thing, the voice become different now, okay, and different thing like the hair growth on the legs and hands. So these are some common changes which seen in boys and girls both. But some different changes due to male and female reproductive system hormones. In male, testes release testosterone hormone, and in female, ovary release estrogen and progesterone hormone. So these hormones are responsible to develop secondary sexual characters in male and females. Testosterone hormone develops secondary sexual characters in male. So what will be the changes we can see in the boys? The voice become more cracker, the voice become more heavy. Okay, another difference, their shoulders become more broader, more muscles, and the hairs are started to appear on faces. Okay, and these are some common, these are the changes which we can observe in boys, or it can be observed as a secondary sexual characters. In female, what are the changes in that puberty age, or what are the secondary sexual characters? That in girls, the mammary glands are going to develop and the menstruation cycle also gets started. What it is, that we will discuss later on. So these are the secondary sexual characters which are commonly visible in boys and girls, and this age is known as puberty. In girls, this age is near 10 to 12, and in boys, it is this age is 13 to 14. So now, in today's class, we will discuss about male reproductive system. What are the organs make male reproductive systems and helps to develop a secondary sexual characters? In the age of puberty, when the male reproductive systems, these are the most, these are the main parts. First part which is very important, that is testes. The first male reproductive part is testes. A pair of testes is present which is located inside one sac like structure. You can see this is a testes and this is located inside the sac like structure. This sac like structure is known as scrotum sac. This sac like structure is known as scrotum sac. What is the function of this scrotum sac? This scrotum sac provides optimum temperature to testes. Testis releases testosterone hormone, which is responsible for secondary sexual characters. Meanwhile, testis releases sperms also. But to release the sperms, it required an optimum temperature. It required a less than our body temperature. And this less than body temperature nearby, less from our body, 3 degrees Celsius. So this temperature is going to be provided by scrotum sac. This scrotum sac provides the optimum temperature. What it is? 3 degrees less from our body temperature. That is going to provide by this scrotum sac. Due to this, the testis release sperms. Testis release sperms, and sperms are male gametes. Sperms are male gametes. Now, when the testis release sperms, it entered on just about one attached coil-like tube-like structure is present, which is called epididymis. So that means this is a second male reproductive system organ. What it is? Epididymis. Just above the testis, epididymis, a coil tube-like structure is present, which is called epididymis. It is also called storage house of sperms. It is also called storage house of sperms. Why? Because what? The testis release sperms that comes and going to collect inside the epididymis. Okay, so it is also called storage house of the sperms. Now, from the epididymis, these sperms enter a tube-like structure which is called vas deferens. This is a third male reproductive part. What it is? Vas deferens. This epididymis now open into a tube-like structure which is called vas deferens. So you can see this structure is called vas deferens till here. Now here very interesting thing that from the urinary bladder in our excretory system we have learned the urinary bladder finally open into urethra. So this is a urinary bladder and this is urethra. So this urethra also open into this. So what we can see, this seminal vesicle also open into urethra. And this urinary bladder also open into urethra. So this is now urethra, which finally open into the fourth main part of male reproductive system, which is called penis. So what we have seen here that this vas deferens open into urethra and urinary bladder also open into urethra. And this urethra finally from whatever the outlet of this body, penis. Okay, so this urethra open through the penis. Now, so what we can say, the sperms which travel through the vas deferens, it's open into urethra, urinary bladder, urine also get open into urethra. That means what we can say that urethra is a common passage for sperms and urine. Vas deferens also open into urethra and urinary bladder also open into urethra. So from the vas deferens sperms comes and from the urinary bladder urine comes. So urethra is a common passage for sperms and urine. Urethra is a common passage for sperms and urine. That's why it is called urogenital system. Urogenital tract. What it is commonly called? Urine say, and genital sperms. That means it is called urogenital tract because it is a common passage for sperms and urine. Because it is a common passage for sperm and urine. So if an objective question is asked, what is the common passage for sperms and urine, you have to write urethra. Okay, now so the sperm comes from vas deferens and finally it's coming to urethra. This urethra finally open out through penis. So penis is a fourth main male reproductive part. So there are four main parts of male reproductive system. First is the testis, second is epididymis, third is vas deferens, and fourth is penis. So these are the main male reproductive parts. Now we will discuss accessory glands. Accessory which assist this main parts. So there are three accessory glands are present in male reproductive reproductive system. There are three accessory glands are present in male reproductive system. The first accessory gland is seminal vesicle. First accessory gland is seminal vesicle. This seminal vesicle, a pair of gland is present in male reproductive system, which is irregular in shape and pouch in shape. So it is called seminal vesicle. These are in pair, which secrete one whitish color fluid, which activate the sperms and which nourish the sperms. So it helps to nourish the sperms and activate the sperms. So what is the function of seminal vesicle fluid? It activates the sperms and it nourishes the sperms. Second accessory gland is prostate gland. This prostate gland also secretes one of fluid. This fluid gives mobility or motility to sperms. It gives movement. Okay, how the sperms get movement due to this prostate gland fluid gives mobility to sperms. And the third, along with these two glands, one more gland is present in male reproductive system, which is called Cowper's gland. What is the function of this Cowper's gland? Cowper's gland secretes one fluid which, along with one mucus, a sticky mucus substance. This mucus lubricates the penis tip at the time of copulation. Okay, so this Cowper's gland's secretion mucus lubricates the penis at the time of copulation. This is the function. So here we discuss three glands. Which one? First is seminal vesicle, a whitish color fluid which gives nourishment to sperm. Second, prostate gland, a fluid which gives mobility to sperm. And third is Cowper's gland, which mucus lubricate the penis at the time of copulation. So these are the accessory glands. Now, the secretion of the seminal vesicle, prostate gland and Cowper's glands. This secretion. So the secretion of this glands, secretion of these glands plus what is coming from vas deferens? Sperms. So this is known as semen. Okay. Secretion of this all three glands and sperms is known as semen. So that means through the penis, the secretion which is transferred into the female vagina. What it is actually? Semen, not only sperms. It is semen. What is semen? The mixture of secretion of all three glands plus sperm is known as semen. So this is all about male reproductive system, main parts, accessory parts. Now I am going to repeat once again all the main parts and accessory parts. First main part is testis. A pair of testes is present in male reproductive system which secrete testosterone hormone. This testosterone hormone is responsible to develop secondary sexual characters in male. Testes secrete sperms. Testes located inside the scrotum sac. Which provide optimum temperature. That means it provides a less than 3 degrees centigrade temperature from 3 degrees centigrade from our body temperature, which helps to release sperms. So due to that, the testes can release sperms. After releasing sperms, it comes and stored inside the epididymis. That's why this polytubular shaped structure is known as storage house. Storage house of sperms. Then this epididymis is open into vas deferens, which is a tube-like structure which open into urethra. From urinary bladder also this urethra comes out. So the vas deferens sperms and urinary bladder's urine both comes and enter in urethra. So the urethra is a common passage for sperms and urine. That's why it is called urine genital tract. Now this urethra finally open into the fourth male reproductive part, which is penis. This is the outlet body parts which passes sperms in female vagina. Along with these four main parts, three accessory glands are also present. First is seminal vesicle, irregular pouches, a pair of irregular pouches are present in male reproductive system, which secrete whitish fluid, which activate and nourish the sperm. What is the function of seminal vesicle? Very important. It flows, activate and nourish the sperm. Second accessory gland is prostate gland. Its fluid gives mobility to sperms. Very important. And third gland is Cowper's gland, which secretion mucus, lubricate the penis at the time of copulation. So this is about the accessory glands. Then the secretion of all three glands, fluid plus sperm, is known as semen. Is known as semen. So through the penis, the semen is going to transfer in female vagina. So this is all about male reproductive system. In our next class, we will learn about female reproductive system. Go through the notes.